it up in here a little bit.
Hey!
To bring grace, the shadows will lead you to spirit. can still dwell when you're at work too. Or if you're on the street somewhere, he can dwell in his house. You just stay right there. You know who he is. Can't be afraid when you dwell. It won't, it'll leave you. Hallelujah. Dwelling in you, God. For you today, so you can chew and digest it. Don't spit it out now. Stand to your feet as we announce. Hey, you got another name, y'all. Well, he always had his name. King!
Expecting some things to happen still, and it's still not happening. Expecting some things to work out, it's still not working out. Now, you know you're doing better than what you were doing before. You know, we always go to God like he's Santa Claus and said, we've been good. Saying, you know, all these things that happen, but it still ain't happening. Still, they still coming at you now. You still, as songwriter says, I would jump the time and wonder how to keep from going under. You be sitting there, you wondering why stuff still be going the same way with you. You know, you know that you're not gossiping like you used to. You ain't as hateful as you used to be. Hello, I'm talking. You know, you done cut back and held back. You even trying to act like you want to diet right now. Hello, I'm talking to somebody. You acting like you trying to be nice right now. You acting like you trying to be good. You know, I'm talking to somebody right now. We just got this thing going on. But at the end of the day, he said you disobey, but you want to play. And you disobey, you want to play simply because you stay. What do you mean, Pastor? See, until you can obey God, you can't keep playing with God. See, it's not about being good. It's not about what you decide to give up. But it's about what he tells you to do that you don't want to do. That you do. Oh, I'm talking to somebody right now. It's about not taking of your shortcomings for his upbringing. See, you go to God, he tells you to do a thing, and you've got all the excuses why you can't do it. I can't do it because I don't have enough finances. I can't do it because I don't have enough education. I can't do it because something more swirly and worthy in my mind. I can't do it, I can't do it, I can't do it. God said you can do it if you put your back into it. See, you got to get to a place where you start actually obeying while you staying, so you can be playing Himalaya on top of the mountain. See, you got to be able to go in there, and you got to really put yourself into what God is telling you to do simply by obeying. What has God told you to do that you refuse to do? Did he tell you to go get the house for $3,000 a month, but you refused to do it because your credit couldn't get it? Did he tell you to go out there and give something to someone, but you didn't give it to them because you said, I don't have enough money of my own? I only got a few dollars. But you know, in tricky land, a few dollars will make you holler. Hello? So here we are in a situation where you got a couple dollars, but you won't let them go because you're trying to figure out where they got to go. But they can't go, and they can't grow until you let them go. Your money can't grow until you let them go. And you gotta let them go when he tells you so. Not where you want to grow, but where he tells you so. Everybody can keep buying bad lot of little Raheem sneakers. But how about the good little boy and he needs some sneakers? Oh, we're going to do Raheem because this is my son? Well, Raheem ain't deserve them sneakers. This little boy did deserve the sneakers. Raheem had you. This little boy got nobody. So you made the choice to get bad little Raheem some sneakers instead of doing the little boy. How about you did the little boy for once? Why don't you obey God? That's a helping you. Just because they ain't your biological, don't you know biological is another word for biological warfare? Everything that's been going wrong in your life has been connected to a biological. Uh-oh. Some of y'all that got touched unworthily because of a biological. Some of y'all got caught up on the drugs because of a biological. Some of y'all is in all kind of debt because of a biological. My God, some of you got some bad DNA because of a biological. It's called biological warfare. You keep fighting to stay in when God is trying to kick you out. You won't obey and leave them alone. You want to stay and play. Now your hair is gray. Talking about you, talking about me, talking about we. See, the problem is, biological is what got you to where you at. But you need to go with your organical. stay, and that's where you lay. That's why you keep laying down for the get down. That's why you can't never be around. See, you keep laying because you keep playing. But you need to start obeying. Uh-oh, let the preacher say.
Amen.
I'm not telling you to obey me. I'm just a man. But I'm telling you to obey the master's plan. Obey the master's plan. Obey the master's plan. He who has you in his hand. Let's talk about this. What I'm saying is your disobedience, you call it rebellion. You call it passive aggressive. You call it whatever you want. I call it foolishness and time foolery and foolery time foolery. Like Thomas, you want to see God's hands. And like Thomas, you'll never see the promised land. Stop trying to see God's hand. Stay in his hand instead of trying to see it. Stay in his hand instead of trying to see it. Shut up and stop walking this way and talk this way. See, you got to start. Walk this way, talk this way, but the most important, obey this way. God said that you will get out at this time because of this. The children of Israel were the children of disobedience. But even the children of disobedience came out. So children of disobedience, he said, 40 days of disobedience, one day God answered, I am in. You can call your 40 any kind of way you want it, but you've been disobeying God for more than 40 days. But he's only counting the 40 days that you disobeyed. Of disobedience, and one day, I'm talking to you right here, and one day, God will answer. And when he answers, he's going to say these words to you. I am here. That's all you want. You ain't going to be a whole lot of rap, a whole lot of this, that, the other. He says that one day, God answered, he will say, I am here. See, the thing is, you keep doubting with disobedience shows God that you doubt what he's about to do. Your disobedience shows God you don't trust him. Your disobedience means you don't even trust him about what he got to say good about you. You'd rather go along with the biological warfare telling you about you instead of going by what God Almighty is saying about you. What is he saying about you? He said, I answer, and I am he. And if I am he, you are me. See, you don't the attorney that got you out that mess, he said, I am he. It wasn't your credit that got you the press. He said, I am he. You know, my God, you didn't wake up on you and said, I am he who woke you up. My God, wherever you got to, he said, I am he. Wherever you got to, he said, I am he. You said, I am he who saved you, and I am he who made you. But I'm not here to play you.
That's right.
Isaiah 41, representing the 40 days that you were disobedient, and the one day that God will answer. And he alone get the credit for what is about to happen to you. Yeah. treat your brother, you act like you ain't deserve it. Some of y'all is ridiculous. You know you've been horrible. You know you ain't been thinking about God. He's just that. You sometimes you sit up there in front of people and say, I know not that man. You get in front of the landlord and they talk to Trey and say, I know not that man. How about you tell them, I know that man. You better watch your mouth. You get in the banks and say, I know not that man. You get around your biological family when they break out the head and you say, I know not that man. When a problem real comes up, you say, I know not that man. So you go to grandma, what big teeth you have, the biological, to ask her to fix your situation instead of going, he who fixes it. So you rather go to grandma because you know not that man. If you're afraid right now, you are telling God, I know not that man. But if you know that man, and you know. Sunday. Why you give me your resume? Yes, I did this. I was bad. I was good. I was bad. Yeah. Okay, good. Yeah. Now, I don't know how this works. There you go. What you mean on that? What you talking before, bro? Sis? Well, I don't know how. Then why are you in front of me? Because you're telling me you don't know that mind. And if you don't know that mind, I don't know you. Gonna happen. I'm so scared. You sitting in a sanctuary in the hand in front of the man that has the plan, and you talking about you don't know? Oh, that's right. I thought you, that's why you originated the plan. So you're sitting in front of God, telling God about his plan that you know nothing about. Or while you're doing that, he puts a messenger to deliver the plan, and you're trying to snatch the plan out the hand. Because you decided you wanted to make a stand. Now give yourself a hand of applause. See you well, baby. Because what is being told to you, you do not want to do that. How many things have you messed up in your life because you just simply did not want to? You couldn't just shut your mouth and go do it. You had to discuss it. So here you are. Remember, this realm is a big battlefield. And the enemy has nothing but snipers everywhere. Looking at you through a scope. The devil, demons. You middle of the battlefield trying to get an understanding. While bullets is flying. You're in the middle of your situation. You need some instruction. I'm trying to keep you from destruction. We ain't got time to instruct. You got to just obey. Damn! Shut up! Let me see. Hello. Here you go. Watch this. So God turned around and put this throne up here for you. As you go, got it all ready. Didn't on the low. He didn't tell nobody because he is he. God is he. He don't need to tell nobody. Put it over there. Messenger comes and says to you, hey, God got the throne over there for you. I'm gonna need somebody. Come here. You come here. I need you to see this. No, matter of fact, don't get about you. You just over here somewhere.
Over here, y'all.
She over here. They said devil with the red dress on. She the devil right now. She got a blue dress. Oh, wow. So here you are. God got this gold throne for you. And in that throne, he got the crown, he got the money, he's got everything. So I'm saying, listen. God got this throne for you. And he's got this money for you. He got this thing. I'm going to beat you while you stand here. Well, how's that supposed to happen? My credit is bad, and everybody keeps messing with me. Stuff is going wrong. Everything is going wrong. How is he going to do that for me? How he's going to give me that crown and do all this stuff, and how I know what you're saying is right? And I'm saying, like musical chairs, you better go sit on that throne before the enemy gets to it. No, you disobeying. You in my face. Meanwhile, he still can't see where the throne is at. The enemy still can't see. He's still trying to find it. So look at her and listen to her. So yeah, so I don't know what's that. It might be in front of the altar at the sanctuary, but even if this sitting there, my legs ain't working right. I ain't got no gas, I ain't got no car, and this, that, and the other. And anyway, why are you coming for me? Listen, man, you need to go ahead and get the chair. Oh, why? You trying to control me? You trying to tell me? No, you need to go get the chair. What you trying to, why we got to do all that? What, can the chair hold me? How big is it? What color is it? I'm saying, can I afford it? Am I in a car? Can I get it in my car? Can I get it in the house? I don't know. Where is that? I don't know. What are you saying? And why should I say that? What you want for that? If I go get that, you want a piece of the chair? Now pick up the chair and walk away.
Oh, man.
By the time you finally decided to obey, go over there and look for the chair. It's gone. All that time I wasted, the enemy is locating where your stuff at because you're doubting. You're not obeying. You're giving them time to locate. See, your blessings like that. Stay right there. Your blessings is like this. It will show up in a place. A message will come. You got to move just like that. Because if you don't, you start complaining. He can locate it and snatch it like she just did for it. And when you go to look for that thing, when you go to look for it, it ain't there. Now you come back to me. See, I did what you said. I listened to you. And now it ain't there. You lied to me. What kind of prophecy is that? That was a prophecy. You made it up. Nothing. Why would I make it up? Can you give me, I ain't no fortune telling you. Give me 10,000 to reach your palm. So here you are. You have missed it. Because you sat there running your mouth. Put the chair back. So I'm telling the enemy, put that chair. Let it go. Girl, I'm gonna knock the jewels off your face. Get over here.
Amen.
Be on.
Be on.
Bucky ain't got a problem. So meanwhile, so now after I relocated, go sit down. You got no business touching that. It don't belong to you. Take your little natural and sit down. Then I'm back here again. So, the chair's over here now. You still running your mouth. But God said, for 40 days you've been doing this nonsense. So, this first day, he says, now go get the chair. Go sit. See, there you go. I'm glad you listened to her. And now, because she said, what God had for her is sitting there, and she's sitting on his throne, and then he says to you, I told you.
That's right.
Now, why now? You get up, and we'll take you, in your chair and move it over there. Over here. Take it with you. Watch what I'm getting ready to show you. Because she obeyed and she went and gathered that chair. Go get your daughter and put your daughter on that chair. As a matter of fact, do this. Give her all the importance. Your obedience goes to the next generation. Your disobedience goes to the next generation. Because as you're doing what you're doing, God is setting you up to set up for the setup. So now she obeyed, and her obedience ended up being child's obedience, was ended up being her children's obedience, and the blessing and the throne goes from place to place, and the throne goes from place to place to place to place to generation to generation to place to place. when someone starts to obey and move, when God says, grab another throne. That one. Don't worry about what's in the way of what's there. Just grab the throne. Don't give the enemy a time and put it up here. Now, go get her. Yes. Your doubt, with your thoughts, with your bad attitude, you are sapping the strength of the environment that you're in. You are sapping the strength of your household. You're even physically killing your engine in your car. Some of your cars is running bad because the spiritual energy you're putting in this car is zapping it. You ever seen like everything that's around you is just turning black? It is. Cause of your mouth. You are caught, your attitude. You are calling stuff in. Darkness over here. Come and get it. And everything in that environment is fighting that darkness. So your environment is no longer a fortress. It is losing strength. That's how demonic forces get in your household. That's how demonic forces get inside your car. That's how demonic forces get inside of you. Because your spiritual immunity system is down. You ran down your spiritual immunity system. Talking to you, talking to me, talking to we. See, if you are going through a thing right now, disobedience will wear down your spiritual immunity system. That's the same thing. If they are negative and they got a bunch of bad stuff to say all the time and everything's wrong, it's wearing you down. It's wearing your immunity down. It's like being next to somebody with spiritual COVID. That's right. See, I had no problem with COVID when it came because all I wanted understand what it was before you got there. That's why I never had a bunch of stuff in my space anyway. Because I know if you got the wrong stuff in your space, it's going to contaminate you and it's going to draw your energy. Y'all getting it this morning?
Yeah, hallelujah.
So he says, and then he said, first off, you got to shut your power hole. Then, the reason why I said it, doing it, because you're contaminating everything around you. You're the one carrying the COVID in the spirit. Yeah. Touching everything.
My God.
Yeah, my bills are already passed through. She keeps talking about me. I don't know how to get gas in the car to run up to $5 a gallon. Man, I don't have any money, man. What's happening? It is bad out here. Ain't nobody got no money. We ain't got no money, bro. Bro, listen. Yes, son. I'm telling you right now, I got little balls in here. Everything. I don't know what I got to do. I might have to start selling some suits, man. I'm telling you, gonna buy a couple, bro. Well, that's right, you broke too. Okay. I get it, hey. Listen, I'm telling you right now, I'm at $5 a gallon. I know you travel real far, so it's got to really cost you like $100 a week. Yeah, so maybe $200. Yeah, I feel you. I'm only right around the corner, though. But it's really hurting me. I know it's got to be hurting you. Yeah, I'm just telling you right now, you said, yeah, now there's nothing going on. You got this car and all this kind of stuff. For this. It's killing you come up and you traveling like she traveling. How y'all doing it? My God, you ain't gonna have to, why you gonna have to stop getting a nice hair because you know you gotta put gas in the car because it's a lot of money. So you know we all gonna be looking busted up for this beast because we ain't gonna have no money for no hair. We got to get gas. Yeah, brother, I'm telling you right now. I'm sitting around, man. Look, I got two pockets empty and everything, man. I'm trying to go vacation and everything, but don't see how I'm going to do it because, you know, you got a family, you got all these bills, and, you know, your wife, she's expensive, and all these things are costing, and you sitting up there, and you trying to, man, we can't even get a sandwich no more. We can't go to the gym. I'm just saying, this is really out to span. And everything, and she's probably complaining. I know my wife is complaining, so I know your wife got to be complaining because, you know, they want all this time. We got to work, but, you know, how we going to work, and, you know, and everything. And then they talking, you know, the church stuff, this is too much. I mean, how we going to do all this, man? I know I'm gonna do it. How you gonna do it? I know I'm about to throw in the towel. You might need to do the same. I done ran my mouth to all them people and contaminated everybody with some mess. Now you said after a while you sitting there percolating with let me get no hair. Be right. I'm gonna get some hair. This guy's gonna be like, oh man, I got no money, man. That's true, man. I can't even go do nothing, man. I'll do something. Yeah, well, ain't nothing positive, don't let me go for the negative. I'm saying, but I got to get mine, you know. You start that, man, listen, I don't know what's going on, bro. We look, man, we ain't going guys trip, leave them chicks home. We gonna go down to Tijuana. We put out less money and have more fun. Ha! All these things, because I'm running my mouth, has contaminated everything. When I should have shut up and obeyed God, because while I was doing all that talking, God had already told me where to go and what to do to get it, but I did not want to do that. So God told me, he said, listen, you got to stop working so much hours at that place. I need you to go and spend some time at the food bank. In your overtime time. I ain't doing that craziness. I use my extra money. And free? I got bills. So you're telling God you got bills. You're telling God you're not going to do it, even though he told you to do it. How many times you been to the grocery line, you had extra food stamps, you could have bought that poor lady something you did, because I got to get through the rest of the month. and the rest of the month don't come, within the second week you back to figure out what you're going to do. Y'all back there, you got the hookups in the house. So it is. It's good business. You know, we know who hookups it is. Stop acting like, I'll tell you later. So here it is. Let the people renew their strength. Why don't you start obeying God? And why you start shut your mouth and start obeying God so that the things around you can start healing? The people around you start healing so it can be a present help to you. And then after that, after you shut your mouth and you give them time to get themselves together from the damage you did, then let them come near. Why are you worrying about you around you when you all up in your misery? You just gotta have everybody in it. I don't want nobody in my business till something wrong goes wrong. I'm gonna tell y'all something. Perfect example. Somebody died in the family. This is the first thing everybody do, especially put on the book. This is what they do. They put in, I give you my condolences. There's no wonderful fruit basket. There's no check or offer and assist you. We're not just condolences. Well, condolences. Oh, but guess what, though? They're giving condolences because you probably already wore them out anyway. In most cases. How many times have you had something going on and people that usually help you just didn't help you? You were pissed off. Because you've been negative for months. Now they ain't got nothing. You don't warm out. God said, let them renew their strength. Let them get strong again while you get strong from shutting your mouth, talking against yourself. He says, watch this. God told me to tell you, why don't you renew your strength too? Because you're doing it to yourself. How about this? How about you ain't even going far with your strength? You're sitting here and beating yourself up. Yeah. Yourself. I've seen people work themselves into a frenzy. They get one call that their electric bill is 30 days past due. For the past few years, their electric has been 90 days past due. But just because now it's finally cost of COVID, you got it up to date. And you weren't worried about it then. When it was 90 days past due, and you had to pay for it, you wasn't even worried about it. You was like, shoot, they're gonna turn it on, I don't care. I don't have a party tonight. I give you a generator or something. I'm doing what I'm doing. I ain't worried about it. Listen, you still go out there and buy five bales of Peruvian and all kinds of stuff. You get the Henny for you, get the Rock Duck for somebody else, but you had a whole lot of it. And still didn't pay the electric bill. 90 days, didn't pay. God comes in, COVID comes in, pay out the electric bill, get you up to date. You ain't even 30 days late. Oh, God. I ain't seen the check yet. They about to turn my stuff off. Because they ain't sent me the check yet. I don't know what's going on. I'm almost 30 days. And then if I don't do it in 30 days, then the bill going to get big again. Then I ain't able to pay that. Because then I'm going to be, next thing you know, they're going to be up there talking. They're going to cover my lights. I got a big 75-inch. I got 375s here. I ain't going to be able to look at them. My internet's not going to work. And if my internet's not working, I don't know how I'm going to do that. And then on top of that, I just started back working. So they taught me they're going to lay me off because I ain't going to be able to come there iron because my electric's off. And it ain't working. And all that. And then I can't get no more help from my heap. I done already tapped them 100 times. So I'm done there. You know, I know I got a check coming from them, but they're not going to give me a big check for not paying electric because they lay on the check. And you just did all this stuff. Just to find out that the day before that envelope that was unmarked was the check, you just put it up there, but you was complaining why you had the check in your hand. So you're zapping your own strength in your head because you refuse to obey God. God says, stop talking, shut up, and stop believing, but you still keep talking. You can't even pay him to shut up. What's wrong with you when God can't tell you to shut up? Now let your boot slap you upside the mouth, you shut up then. Your girlfriend to cut you off, you shut up. You say one more word, I won't cook another. You know what? You do one more thing. You better be in here by 9. You be in here by 7. Male or female, it don't matter. Everything you can obey for God. He says, now, renew the strength. Let them come near. Now that you've got good, positive things going on inside of you, why won't you start listening to the positive things that's coming to you? And start obeying what's positive that's coming to you. If God sends somebody to tell you that's not going to happen, then you're going to listen and you're going to be set, ready, set, go. It is not going to happen. And you're going to start saying it's not going to happen. And I know that God's going to show me how I'm supposed to get out of this. And I know I'm getting out of this. I'm not just getting out. I'm going to come out better, so much better. Because the minute you start obeying, your messenger will come near. Your answer will come near. Your healing will come near. What you want will come near. And the word says, that's why it hasn't come near. He said, then let them speak. And when it comes to you, it's going to speak. It's going to tell you just how it's going to be. It's going to speak. Somewhere, somehow. Person, place, or thing is going to speak to you and let you know. He says, then when this happens, he says, now let us come near together to judgment. What that means is this. When you come together in this thing, God will be looking at you at that point to see if you obeyed or not. Verse 2. Who raised up the righteous man from the east, called him to his foot. Do you ever realize why in our area things happen different? Because we are in the east, the northeast. See, the church of Philadelphia, I'm going to give you a little tidbit of some information. Well, everybody wants to run down south anywhere, you might not want to. The Church of Philadelphia is literally in Philadelphia. Literally. By directions. Jesus was born where the North Star was the highest in the sky. So if you're in the north, you're closer to where the North Star is to where you can see when that day comes on his birthday. One. Two, we're in the east. Now, naturally, New Jersey and this area is on granite. They're hard tectonic plates, so we don't get attacked by earthquakes and things that nature and bad weather changes because we're sitting in a rock steady air. And then I hear a word in the Bible says, upon this rock I'll build my church. So here we are in this place where this is going on. Now, in addition to that, okay, New Jersey itself is a peninsula. It's surrounded by waters on the east, on the west, and in the south. But in the north is to the mountains. Uh-oh, see y'all working. So you're in a place, you're in an actual fortress of God by the location itself. So he says, Who raised up the righteous man from the east? So something's going to raise up. There's going to be a man, or I would say woman of God in some instances, that's going to come from that east place. It's gonna, when the sun rises, it's going to rise.
Yes.
It's going to rise.
Yes.
There's going to be a person that called him. him to his foot. That's going to be obedient and obey. And was willing, there's the obedience. So why don't you be the person that decide to rise? Why don't you decide to be the person that's like that? Stand up in front of God. Kings are obeying and giving up everything they got. And you don't have a whole lot. You can't give them that. Uh-oh, I'm talking to somebody right now. If the kings can't give anything they got, why can't you give everything you got for God? If the kings are down now, why can't you craziness. You know what he's doing for you.
Yes,
you
know,
he let you go down.
Hallelujah.
God pursued you. If you was going to go down, you'd be down on him. If you was gonna be done, you've been done already. If you was gonna be stuck in that rotten place you in, my God, you would have never made there in the first place. My God, if you think that you was gonna be stuck because you keep depending on love.
Way off by yourself.
things that's good, all the things that's good. My God, I did it, I was good, I did it, I did it, I didn't quit it, I did it. No matter how you disobeyed me, I did it. Every day, every night, every hour, every second, every day of your life, I did it. From the generations, from the beginning, from the beginning. Soon as you took your first step, your first breath, your first move, your first fall, your first failure, your first win, your first thought, the name of first, all your first, I was there. I took you from beginning to the end. I was there, the beginning to the end. In the beginning, my God, in the beginning, I'm in the beginning of your new life. I'm in the beginning of your new life. The name of Jesus, depend on me. Watch, I will show you how deep is the sea. Depend on me. I'm the Lord. I'm the Lord, the first. I am the first. I was here when there was no time. I was there in time, out of time. My God, realms I travel back and forth. The name of Jesus in the darkness in your mother's womb. I was the first that taught you. I was the light that fired the air, the fire, the sea. I was the first. My God wants me. I was the first that made you understand. I was the first that wrote your life plan. I am the first that called you, seen you, been with you, walked with you, talked with you, moved with you. I was the first, the beginning, but not the last. I am the first. My God, your last is your past. Your last is your past. I'm back to the beginning when you win in your present situation. Come forth. The name of Jesus is time for you to know. I was first. I was first. I was the second. Was the chicken dinner the winner? I was first. Stuff is going to be going down. But you're going to notice that while everything else is going down, you're prospering. You're going to notice why they can't get it, you feel it. You need to understand why people are just going to say yes to everything you ask. Then you're going to wonder why you don't feel like being around them like that no more. There's some people and places that you just ain't going to feel like no more. You ain't going to want to be fine. You ain't gonna want to talk to them. They're gonna be mad at you when you because he's made you the first while he always kept you being the last. And your last is your past. And your last is your past. And your last is your past. And he says, I am he that will bring you to your place. of greatness. In this year of 2022, I am he who has fixed your situation to the generations. I am he, follow after me. I am he that will set you free. I am he, if you follow after me, as far as you can see. I am he that changed you, made you the image of me. I am he that caused you to be on the throne, but the throne means sometime you got to stand alone. I am he that changed your situation. I am he to wound you from a new generation. I am he who loves you when nobody loves you. I am he that goes against your loneliness. I am he, no more fear. I am he, God is here. God is here. I am here, no anxiety. My God, if you chase after me, I am he, no depression. My God, if you stay after me, I am he who healed your body, healed your mind, healed your finances, healed your thoughts, healed your house, healed your children, healed your car, the dog, and everything that's around you. I am he. For the 40 days of your disobedience, one day, in your present place, before this year is out, right now, if you obey, God is answering. He says, when I do it, remember, I am here. Don't forget me. I'm here. Don't forget me. I'm here. Don't forget me. Some of y'all are looking for something to happen on the media. If you need it to happen on the media, you need to start obeying. Don't do things the same way. Finish it. Even if it looks impossible, finish it. Finish it. Don't be afraid. Don't worry about the finances. Stop depending on your finances. That's a lie. It's God. He's the one. He will bring you the money, but you gotta be bold enough to stand up against that. No fear. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I touched the agreement that he who is bold enough. Right now, in the name of Jesus, who is bold enough to believe him for real this time. For all of you, not some of you. For all of you. Everything that you have been searching for right now. Whoever it is. And if that's the case,